Hello, hello, everyone.
Welcome, welcome, welcome.
I, too, like Rue, am very tired. I feel like, I don't know, man, every day I have off from my actual job, I've just been dead tired lately. I don't know exactly why. We're playing on Expert, by the way. If I had access to the higher difficulty to Proud mode, I'd be playing that. But yeah, like, I've just been wanting to sleep, and that's pretty much it. But, yeah, no. I'm just glad I did get a tiny bit of work done before the stream started today. Not as much as I wanted to, but some, and I'm happy with that, you know? Some is better than none. But that's why I was a little bit late today. Just working on things for the stream, the channel, stream adjacent, all that sort of stuff. The classic intro to Kingdom Hearts 1. I mean, we played this game for the PS2 Gauntlet. I don't remember how long ago. It wasn't super long ago, and then I've played this game a good handful of times growing up. On the PS2, and then again on the PS3, and then again on the PS4, and I want to play it again on the PC, but I don't buy games on the Epic Games Store, and it's not available on Steam yet, so haven't got to do that yet. But one of these days, if Square ever decides to come to Steam, let's go. You're about to say we played this before I remembered it was Wednesday. Yes, no, this is the new game for us to finish. We are... Ow, I just smacked my fucking mic stand, dude. Hey, here's the bop. Yes, it's really, really good. The reason why like, last time we did it, I just let it play. The only reason why I'm not just, like, shutting up now to let it play is because... Turns out Square doesn't particularly like this song being on the internet. So, I mean, I'm sure it's going to get flagged anyways, but whatever. It's not that big of a deal. They're not, like, copyright striking people or anything, just taking what's duly theirs, which is understandable. What was I saying? Oh, yeah, no, this is the game that we rolled on to complete, so we're going to be playing through this game. I don't think I'm going to do a 100% run on it or anything. We might do all secret bosses, though. Not positive, but maybe. We'll see. We'll see. It depends. By the time we beat the game, it depends on how tired of it we are. I would really like to get the secret ending, but you have to... On Proud mode, I think you just have to beat the game. On Expert, which is what we're on, I'm not sure... What rules you have to follow to get the secret ending? I'd have to look it up. It's been too long. I'm fighting with getting Dragon Age Origins to run without crashing the last couple days. Ew. That sucks, Nate. Why is it crashing on you, man? Just in case you forgot, Yutada Hikaru? That's her name, right? I'm forgetting, but I didn't know they were non-binary. I had no idea. They make some good music, I'll say that much. At least for the Kingdom Hearts games. I've actually tried listening to some of their other music before. Their name, not her, yeah. I gotcha, my bad. I've listened to some of their music before. It's just not... I don't know, besides the Kingdom Hearts stuff, I don't know, I didn't get that into it. Like, it's fine. It's not bad or anything. But they make some real bops for the Kingdom Hearts stuff. For real, for real. Been wanting to play Dragon Age Origins and Dragon Age 2, but you'd have to pull out your PS3. See, I didn't even know they made those games for PS3 until I was talking to Nate the other day, and they, Nate mentioned that you mentioned pulling out your PS3 to play DAO. So I was like, oh shit, well, I guess it is, man. I have no idea. Step forward. Can you do it? Yes. Yes, I can. I can walk. From what you read, it has a memory leak issue. You selected Vista compatibility, and that seems to have done the trick so far. Here's hoping, my guy. Let's see. We're on hard mode. I usually go... I'm not a big magic user in these games, although magic is strong. So I usually go either shield or sword, and then give up the wand. Ooh, we doing a battle. Let's go, dude. Hey, we won again. Undefeated champions over here, my dude. Did we lose any health or anything? I imagine we should, right? lose some or something whenever we battle. I don't know. I mean, we got some experience or something. I don't know, whatever. Anyways, you got some light strips up in your room finally? Dope, dude. I don't know. I've been thinking about doing that one of these days, putting up some light strips and stuff. I think we're gonna go... I mean, that Sephiroth fight has me wanting to go for shield. But let's go sword. We're gonna go sword and probably give up the wand. Because I'm not even 100% sure if we're going to do the Sephiroth fight, all of the hidden bosses and stuff. So, no point in planning ahead for it. And if we do decide to, we can always just grind it out. I don't remember, as a kid, if I ever 100%ed the game or not. I don't think I did. I'm not positive I even ever beat Sephiroth as a kid. I have since then, playing the Kingdom Hearts Final mix on... Hey, a ham bone as a treat for winning the battle? Good idea. But yeah, I know I have... So on the final mix on PS3, I definitely did beat Sephiroth. I 100% of the game outside of the gummy missions on the PS3. Because I just never really cared for the gummy ship stuff. I've thought about going back and doing it just so I can get the stupid platinum for the game. I think you also have to... Was it the PS3 or the PS4 version? One of them, you had to beat the individual difficulties. Like, if you beat the hardest difficulty, it didn't give you the achievement for beating the lower tier difficulties, which was kind of dumb, but whatever. Some meaty meat, my guy. The ones in your window are a smart strip, and the ones in your doorframe are simple ones. Oh. What do you mean by, like, smart strip versus simple? So, like, the simple ones, they're just one solid color forever? Whereas the smart strips, you can change the color? Is that what you were saying? You were just showing Layton our class pet? Gotcha. Well, hello, Noodle. Hello, Layton. If you are still here and or can hear. Use this power to... Oh, God. I'm already screwing up reading. Use this power to protect yourselves and others. The green gauge displays your hit points. You run out of HP, you'll be dead. Blue shows your magic power. You're not going to really use it except for curing yourself. Pretty cool. Oh, yeah, dude. The class pet is awesome, even though they look a little annoyed 90% of the time. they're an angry little dragon. You gain experience by defeating enemies. With enough experience, you gain a level. Furthermore, defeated enemies sometimes leave items behind. You can take these items by walking up to them. Different items can do different things, like restore HP or MP. Better than traumatized? Yeah. Yeah, we did have one traumatized version of Bill. That was a good one. All of them are better than a gooey, drippy bow that we had. That was a rough point in his life. Generally, you'll automatically target the nearest enemy, but you can lock onto a specific target by pressing X1. That's your button on the PlayStation 2 controller. by pressing R1. I remember when I was young, though, I had a code breaker for my PS2. And there were some interesting cheats on there to, like... Apparently, there was, at one point, the developers thought about putting Final Fantasy summons into the game, so you could unlock that as a menu option, but it didn't do anything. It just crashed the game, sadly. Something that was fun, though, you could actually unlock, like, all of these weapons that you use here, like the wand, the sword, the shield, and then even the wooden sword, which doesn't do any damage to the Heartless. You could unlock that, too. As a weapon to use in the actual game. That little stuff was fun. I had fun on with it. Can change color on either one. Has a remote and a few colors, but strip all stay same color. The smart ones you can do on phone or Google Home now has more color options and patterns. Oh, okay. Sure. I gotcha. It's really weird to me. Like, I get used to it pretty quick, but Kingdom Hearts 1, the right analog stick doesn't control the camera, which is just always, like... seemed like a weird choice. I get why they did it, so you can be running around with the left stick and still selecting your commands with the right stick, and then you have R2 L2 to flip your camera around. So, like, honestly, I think it's probably the better control scheme, but it still feels really weird to get used to after playing the newer ones so much more. You gotta be on your Linux final. Go, dude. That's awesome. Good for you. How many years do you have left, Rue? Is it just like you got the next semester, then you're done? Do you have a couple years left still before you're done? The question mark in the command menu turns into various commands. You can use those commands to do various things. Never would have guessed, dude. You can push large crates. Look at us go, dude. You can also smash them. Sora, smash. Let's go. You can take these items by walking up to them. Got Poshin. You got screwed by scheduling a lack of teachers, so you have another year. That sucks, man. Does that mean, like, did you just do less for a little while? Like, instead of a full-time schedule, did you have, like, a three-quarter time schedule for a little bit or something? Or did you end up having to do extra classes because of it? Because that would really suck. That was one of the things I liked about the college that I went to. They did, if you wanted to, full 40-hour weeks instead of the full time for college, I think, is, what, like 12 hours or something like that? 12 credit hours. This is the first time you did 16. Okay, yeah. So 12 or 16, whatever. Something around there is considered full time for a college student. My college let us do 40, dude. So I did 1 year of college. It actually came out to... It was a little over 9 months, because the actual, like, curriculum plan they had was, like, groups of 40, but then for the last quarter of the year, you did, I forget how many hours. It was under 40 for the last group, though. But anyways, I did 40 the full time from beginning to end, and, so in a little over 9 months, I got the equivalent of, 4 years of schooling, and, or not 4 years, of, like, two, three, I don't remember. It's been 10 years, 11 years now since I've been in college. I don't fucking remember, but point is, yeah, I got a lot of credit hours really quickly. You would die from that. See, I was 17 when I started college. I finished when I was, after I turned 18. So, I mean, I was pretty young. I didn't have a real job. I got extra, I had a house to live in, so we didn't have to pay, like, rent or anything like that. So, but I got extra funding to pay, you know, bills for the house, and I had some food assistance. So, like, I didn't have to work a job, so all I had to do was go to college. So that was just basically my first jump into a full-time job, essentially. Obviously, it's not the same thing, and I'll tell you what, I'd much rather go back and do college again than work my full-time job that I work now. But, I mean, it is what it is. Press the select button to shift from first person view. You can then use the stick to look around. Press select now. Look at us go. Do you guys know what the point of these three characters are when you talk to them? I'm pretty sure I mentioned it whenever we did the PS2 Gauntlet episode on it. But they ask you questions. Cameos? They're not just cameos. They are cameos. They're all from Final Fantasy games. But no, it's not just for that. It's, so, what's most important to you is the one they're asking. You can pick any of these three that you want, but each of these three actually changes the experience curve for the game. So, or the experience needed per level curve for the game. If you pick middle, your experience is pretty much flat throughout the game. Like, the amount of experience needed to gain a level is pretty much flat. If you pick three, I think three is the easy one. I don't remember. It's been a little while, but... Three is either you level up super quick in the beginning, but then it takes really, really, really long to level up by the time you're, like, you know, in the 90s or whatever. Whereas the other option, we'll say one as an example here, you'd have to look it up to be sure. You level up relatively slowly in the beginning, but relatively quickly at the end. And if you're going for a full level 99 run, it's actually better to do the Path of Darkness or whatever the hell they say at the end, because it takes the least amount of experience overall to reach level 99. I think they're all option ones is the one that gives you the lowest amount of experience overall needed. It'll, whenever we select all three options, it'll say a thing here about, like, Twilight or Darkness or whatever. You want to be number one, you want to see rare sights, you're afraid of getting old. I think this is the right one for the least amount of experience needed. which is the option I usually end up going for. It does make the early game harder, but makes the late game easier. Your adventure begins at dawn. As long as the sun is shining, your journey should be a pleasant one. No, never mind. Tell me again about the real you. Okay, must be option 3 for each one then. So being indecisive is really scary. I mean, I'm pretty indecisive. My prized possessions are the most important thing to me in my life. Yep, burnt down my house and didn't care. I mean, I cared, obviously, but, you know, whatever. To be strong. Yep, that's why I just, right now, I'm lifting these weights, dude. Getting them gains all day, every day. Let's go. Just fucking... I remember as a kid, I actually tried to, like, pick options based off of myself. I have no idea which thing I got to, but... Your adventure begins in the dead of night. Your road won't be easy, but a rising sun awaits your journey's end. Yeah, that's the one. So, your adventure begins in the dead of night because the early game's going to be harder because you won't level up as quickly. But a rising sun awaits your journey's end because at the end of your level up curve, it's actually much easier. You level up much quicker at the end. So, that's the one I usually end up going for, and that's the one I'm going to go for here as well. It just means in the early game, we might have to grind a bit more, or we might die a bit more. But as time progresses, it should just get easier and easier for us. If we decide to do a full completion run with all of the secret bosses or whatever. Because if we do, we'll probably end up having to grind some stuff out. Press start to open menu. I did. It paused the game. Y'all don't stand a chance. This game really throws me for a loop, man. Like, even to this day, because this beginning section here, where you're just, like, fighting the Heartless, is so relatively easy and everything, right? Like, your intro to combat here is super simple. And then you have the first boss, the shadow version of Sora, the giant one that we're gonna fight here in a moment. And suddenly the game, like, that boss, for a very early fight is actually relatively hard, and probably because I play on higher difficulties, but I've died to that thing a handful of times. There's a chance we will today. So it always just kind of throws me for a loop. Like, this is the intro to the game, and you're gonna just murder us like that? Bro. Oh, other super exciting news. As you guys know, I am into console modding and all that sort of stuff. I don't know if I've ever told you guys, I think I have. I've told you about the memory card I have for the PlayStation 1. It's a really cool memory card that actually uses a micro SD card as your memory card. And because of that, you have essentially infinite memory cards, right? The PS1 memory card held like 8 kilobytes or something stupid. It was a tiny amount. A 1 gig SD card would give you enough memory cards, virtual memory cards, on that thing to last. You could play every single PlayStation 1 game and then some, right? And have your own unique memory card for each one. Really, really cool memory card. You can also do other stuff with it. For instance, with as far as console modding goes, there are memory card exploits for the PlayStation 1 that you can use to boot Japanese games if you import them, just as an example. But anyways, point is, really cool project. I bought one when they released. I love it. I use it anytime I play my PlayStation 1. It's my main memory card. It also has a web portal, so you can, like, back up your saves and stuff. It's amazing. The same team has either made or is almost done with a GameCube version of it. And more importantly for me right now, personally, they announced a PlayStation 2 version that is in the works as well. I'm super excited for that, I'm not gonna lie. I'm going to be buying one probably the day they release, because it's literally the last memory card you ever need. The only reason you would need a second memory card at that point, really, for legitimate console gaming at least, is if a game has that functionality. Like, some games you can, like, if you have a save on memory cards part 2, you can do something special with your game save and memory card slot one and stuff like that. It's like, that's the only reason you would ever need a second memory card at that point. It's pretty sick, man. I'm super excited for it. And I don't know what all features it's going to have on the PS2. Like, on the PS1, for instance, if you use a pretty much any modded way of launching games, it will automatically switch the memory card, like create a new virtual memory card for you for whatever game you're playing, as well as automatically switch to the right one if you're playing with mods, like with a memory card exploit or something like that. And then if you're using like an ODE, it can do the same thing. It can automatically switch memory cards for you. I don't know if they're going to have any sort of functionality like that on the PS2. It would be really, really cool if they did. I'm hoping, you know, fingers crossed, that it'll do it without any sort of mods. But, I mean, if it does need mods for that functionality, whatever. At least you still have the web portal, so you can switch memory cards on the fly from there. And it has physical buttons. The PlayStation 1 version also has... I don't know how it works exactly, because there's no modding you have to do to the actual hardware of the console. Chocobo. It also has, the PlayStation 1 version also has a controller combo. You can hold down a couple buttons and then use like the R and L buttons to switch memory cards, which is really neat. So I'm not sure quite how they make that work, but they do it without any sort of internal modifications to the PlayStation 1, which is really cool. Chocobo hopping in with the with the quotes there from the game. Sora looks like he's wearing contacts in that shot. Not just because of the color blue of his eyes, but, like, there's a little bit of a rim around his eye there. I don't know if you guys saw it or not.
Give me a break, Irie.
Sorry, you lazy bum. I knew that I'd find you snoozing down here.
No, this huge black thing swallowed me up. I couldn't breathe, I couldn't... Ow!
Are you still dreaming?
It wasn't a dream. Or was it? I don't know. What was that place? So bizarre.
Yes, sure.
Say, Kyrie, what was your hometown like? You know, where you grew up?
I've told you before. I don't remember.
Nothing at all?
Nothing.
What? Why, my guy? Why?
Really?
But you know, I wouldn't mind going to see it.
I'd like to see it too. Along with any other world.
My legit, my actual first time playing the game was in Disney World in Florida. That's where I bought the game, and I had just happened to take my PS2 with me for the hotel stay, because we were there for a few days. Anyways, and I saw it in a shop in Disney World, and convinced my friend's mom, because I was there with my friend, to let me borrow money to get it, because my mom had agreed to, you know, pay her back whenever we got back in town. Anyways, I tried out the game. I played the Destiny Island section. And I was like, this isn't that good. Like, I just kind of, I didn't go back to the game for months. I was so bored with the just like running around and whatnot. All the fighting and stuff in the beginning was kind of cool with the intro. But then we got to this stuff and we were just doing like a treasure hunt, basically. Like, I was so disenchanted with the game at that point. Because I had never seen any advertisement for it or anything. I just saw the box and was like, dude, this looks pretty cool. I really, really want this. Something pulled me toward it. Thankfully, though, after a few months getting back home and being a kid, I didn't have a ton of games to play. So eventually I went back to it, figured out how to get through the Destiny Island section, and then absolutely fell in love with the game after that, as should be obvious. But yeah, it threw me for a bit of a loop there at first, I'm not gonna lie. I have read stories of people grinding to like level 99 and stuff on Destiny Island. Those people are insane. That's one challenge I don't think I'll ever do. Even level 15 is insane, man. You had to have spent a long, long time screwing around in Destiny Island to get to level 15, to level 15. Oh, we don't need the mushrooms yet. My bad. We'll come back. We'll be here later. Yeah. Oh, that's rough, dude. I The music was fire, so I didn't care. Just that's all we need, man. Just need to be young, some good music, and you can grind away for hours and hours and hours. I forget all of what we're actually gathering in the beginning. I should have spoke to Kyrie real quick to find out. I think we need cloth, rope, and a couple logs, maybe, for the first set. And then the second set's like water, fish, mushrooms, coconuts. I think that's right. It's been, well, I guess since we played it on the PS2 Gauntlet episode. It's been about since then, since I've thought about how the beginning of this game starts. I mean, I can't say much, though. I played a lot of RuneScape growing up, and that was basically just, you know, the same thing. Just grinding endlessly for hours on end for no real reason.
Hey, Sora! You feel lucky today?
Let's go, dude. I'm going to try, before we leave the island, to beat each one of my friends in combat here. I've never been very good at beating them. I have done it before, but I've never been good at it. And as a kid, I absolutely loved the fact that if you timed your attack right, you get those two extra experience points. I mean, in the grand scheme of things, 2 points is nothing, but, like, I don't know, it just felt really good. I refuse to use potions while fighting these guys. There we go. One down. Two to go, and then we got the group still. And there's always Riku. Riku's the hardest one, of course. Oh. Don't smack the boat. We're gonna pop a hole in it.
Ah, the breeze feels great.
Yeah, fight me now. Oh, the breeze feels great. That's cool. Do you want to fight? Son of a bitch. Should probably lock on. Oh my god. We're going to get our ass kicked by a girl with a jump rope. Why didn't they just use one of those boats? Oddly enough, that has never crossed my mind before. That's a really good point, man. Why didn't they just use one of those boats? Pop a sail on there and get going. It's not like they don't know how to use those boats, because it's canon that they get to this island from a main island. Like, this is just a play island for them, basically, right? You can't see it in any of the shots here, but there's actually another island off in the distance where they all live and where, like, their parents are and all that BS. And ow, dude, come on. And it's kind of insinuated. I hate not having dodge roll or anything. Ah! I suck! It's kind of, you know, insinuated or hinted at that it's the same in this game.
Okay, don't hold back.
Because there's the three boats there. Son of a bitch, I didn't lock on again. At the dock, and you have, I mean, presumably, like, I guess I don't know what the split up would be. In my mind, all three of these people came over here together. And then Sora and Kairi came over together, and then Riku came over on his own. I don't know if that's actually true or not, but that's kind of how I've made sense of it.
You ready?
Aw, son of a bitch.
You ready?
Please just die. Just die, girl. Damn! Why am I struggling so much with this fight, man? I'm not stopping until she dies. Oh, okay. I thought we were gonna get hit there again. We just gotta play it slow. Oh, goodness, Sora. Come at me. There we go. Got our first level up. Some defense. I'll take it. What I'd really like is a dodge roll. Any sort of dodge, man. It always feels weird coming back to Kingdom Hearts 1 and not having any abilities whatsoever in the beginning. Nice. All it took was a little bit of concentration.
I can't believe I lost.
Get over it. Yeah, camera. A lot of people really complain about the camera on Kingdom Hearts 1. I've never hated it. I don't think it's amazing or anything like that, but I don't think it's terrible either. Oh, son of a bitch. There we go. We didn't hit him with it, but there we go. And back up. Nice miss. There we go. I've always found this guy to be one of the easier ones. Not to say I won't die fighting him, but like... because of the whole, you just hit his balls at him and then stun him thing. Like, you're kind of, you're not necessarily forced to go slow, but it's, you're definitely encouraged to go slow with him. Oh, damn. We're too far away. Damn it, dude. Like you said, we'll probably still end up dying to him. Shut up. We're just EXP farming you anyways.
Show me your stuff.
Oh my god, Dearsley. I hate everything right now. I can't get the timing down for some reason to get the balls to hit him. There we go. I'm gonna blame it on the OBS lag, man, from playing through OBS. Come on, throw your balls at me. Please? Oh, we both missed. Come on! Ah! Damn it, dude. Why can I not? I'm just gonna... just gonna wail on him for a little bit. He's annoying the shit out of me. Just go down, dude. Oh, damn it. We don't have any equipment or anything to start with, right? Abilities, anything? Yeah, I didn't think so.
Show me your stuff.
I'm gonna show you some stuff. There we go. Maybe I was just too far away before, and that's why the balls weren't hitting him. Ooh, thought he's gonna throw it there. Oh, damn it, that was way too early. Let's go. Come on, come on, come on. Ah, that was... I don't know why... Oh, God. Nope. I don't know why the second hit missed him. I thought we had that. Am I gonna have to... I might have to turn off OBS, man.
Show me your stuff.
No, we got this. Heart of the cards and all that shit. Nice. At least we're getting extra experience, right? Every time we hit his ball, that's just extra experience points for us. Nice. I tried to dodge roll. Can't dodge roll. Nice, dude. Alright, so that's all three down. Now, do we still need another log, or do we only need one? I don't remember. Let's go talk to Riku, though. Do that. Throw down a quick save, because I don't know, why not? Any moment now. It's working on it. It's slow. Gotta give it its time. It'll get there. I don't think there's anything in this room we need for this section, right? No. So I can't quite remember. It's been a while. Do we need... we need eggs? We don't need eggs for this one, right? Or was it this one that we needed an egg for? Oh my god, it's been forever. I should really just go talk to Kairi is what I should do. Because she'll just, you know, tell us what we need instead of me trying to guess. Okay, I didn't see any eggs up there, so maybe not. Riku, my guy, what's up? Did you get everything you need for that raft? I gave my stuff to Kairi. Hey, Sora, how about a quick round? Grab your sword. You're on, my guy. Get ready to get wrecked. And run away. And hit him. Ooh, another. Oh, goddammit. I wasn't paying attention. We're gonna get wrecked.
Don't tell me you're giving up already.
Yes, I'm giving up already. No. Mm-mm. He's trying to bait us. Damn, dude.
Still don't got it.
You don't got it, dick.
Come on.
Why we need the dodge roll, so whenever he goes on his back like that, we can get the hell away from him. That's, oh, we got lucky. Nope, that's it. Yep. As soon as I saw him go on his back, dude, I knew we were screwed. I'm sure there's some way to, like, prevent him from doing that right there, but I don't know what it is. Also, camera, please. Okay, that was that was a terrible showing. Again! I think if you beat him, like, the first try or something like that, don't you get a better potion or something? I don't know if that's true or if that's just something, like, I read as a kid, or one of my friends told me as a kid, but I remember that being a thing. Ah, oh, dude, we're so fucked.
Don't tell me you're giving up already.
Come on.
My turn.
Ooh. Ooh. Damn, dude. It takes so long for the sword swing animation to end. It's really hard to get away from that. But we have to show our dominance over Riku before we can leave, man. Maybe if we prove that we're better than him, he won't enter the darkness. Oh, hi, Coconut. Damn. Ha! 0-4. Gosh, I suck. Gotta be more aggressive. And then hope that doesn't happen. That's what's gonna get us every time. Can you imagine, though, grinding to level 99 just doing these fights with these four people over and over again? And people have actually done that. Like, that's a real thing people have spent their time doing. You're the one that's going to be giving up when I kick your ass, dude. Mm. I'm so annoyed. It's fine. We got this. This is going to be the fight right here. Watch, we're going to die instantly this time. Okay.
Come on.
I was hoping if we got the stun on him, he wouldn't do the donkey kick. I don't really know. It's not a donkey kick, I guess. I don't know what to call it.
My turn.
Damn. Sometimes you can bait him out in that section, and then like when he swings, he'll miss, and you can get behind him. Nice, nice.
Come on.
I was already too deep. Damn, man, I should have went to the left, not to the right. 0-8. Riku is kicking my ass, man. I'm actually going to, hold on, switch to HDMI 1. Just so we have a tiny bit longer to react. It's not actually going to make a huge difference, but should help a little bit, hopefully. Nope. Why are we climbing trees? I didn't even know you could climb the trees in that section, man, while you're in the middle of a fight. Do your combos slower, yeah.
You still don't got it.
Just years of button mashing and fighting games is what, like, is what killing me here.
You still don't got it.
Nope, still too slow, or too... My reaction time was just too slow on that one. I probably could have got away from it if I wouldn't have pressed X the second time.
You still don't got it.
Nice.
Don't tell me you're...
Nope. I just accepted it. Get off the tree, Sora.
Don't tell me you're giving up already.
Come on. Too slow on that one. Nope. Okay. I'm gonna go talk to Kyrie if we don't kill him in like one or two more tries. But we're not leaving this damn section to like kick this dude's ass.
Don't tell me you're giving up already.
Just fight me. Stop trying to bait. Nope. Damn, dude. And then I'm gonna go make sure we at least have all the stuff that we need.
Don't tell me you're giving up already. Come on. You still don't got it.
Get down here, you dick. Oh, did it not have... Oh, damn it. That's what I get for looking at chat. Does it not have the option to not turn everything in?
You still don't got it.
It really has been too long since I've played, man. I thought whenever you talk to her, you could choose to continue or not. But you might be right. In that case, then I'm not stopping. We'll spend all 3 hours of the stream today or whatever fighting fucking Riku if we have to. Hopefully not. Fingers crossed we don't have to.
Come on.
Damn it. I knew that was gonna happen.
You still don't got it. What are you afraid of? Don't tell me you're giving.
Oh, God. Come on, he's gotta be close. Nice! Let's go. Finally, dude. Finally. 1 to 12 or whatever? But we beat him. That's what matters. Yeah, 1 to 12. Let's go. Kingdom Hearts Masters over here, obviously. Yeah, got a regular potion. Like I said, I fact check me on this, but I'm pretty sure if you beat him first try, you get like a better potion or something instead of just the regular one. I also remember being told as a kid, again, don't know if it's true, but if you collect all the ingredients before you talk to Kyrie, or if you collect all the ingredients without rechecking with Kyrie, like, you can talk to her once, but after that, you'll only get a potion instead of a high potion. Like, if you have to check back with her a couple times. Yeah, see, there was the option there to not pack in for the day. So if we said no there, like, we wanna keep fighting,
so
would that have
Kyrie's
changed things?
Out there somewhere,
I guess,
right?
We should have tried it.
Could be. We'll never know by staying here.
But how far could a raft take us?
Who knows? If we have to, we'll think of something else.
So, suppose you get to another world. What would you do there?
Well, I haven't really thought about it. It's just, I've always wondered why we're here, on this island. If there are any other worlds out there, why did we end up on this one? And suppose there are other worlds. Then ours is just a little piece of something much greater. So, we could have just as easily ended up somewhere else, right?
I don't know.
Exactly. That's why we need to go out there and find out. Just sitting here won't change a thing. It's the same old stuff. So let's go.
You've been thinking a lot lately, haven't you?
Thanks to you. If you hadn't come here, I probably would have never thought of any of this. Kyrie, thanks.
You're welcome.
Everybody on this damn island got the hots for Kyrie. Like, shit, dude.
Sora! You wanted one, didn't you?
Paopu fruit.
If two people share one, their destinies become intertwined. They'll remain a part of each other's lives, no matter what. Come on, I know you want to try it.
What are you talking?
Riku was a little bit of a dick sometime. Picking on poor Sora. It's a great looking JPEG. How did Donald not notice that Mickey was missing, like, as soon as he entered the throne room, you know? Like, bro, are you blind, my guy? Donald, man. He's so fucking useless. I always remember Like, growing up, I didn't know that you could hit the triangle button to get Donald and Goofy to assist you. When I figured that out, man, that just blew my little mind. Like, that was huge. Being able to basically force Donald to use heal magic on you at any point. You just gotta hope that he actually has some magic left so that he can assist you.
Hey there, Donald. Good morning.
We've got a problem, Goofy. But don't tell anyone.
Ooh. Queen Minnie?
Not even the queen.
Daisy?
No!
Yes. Yeah, you can use right stick as menu. In this game, you have to. There's no camera options, if I remember correctly. I'll double check. I might be wrong on that, but I thought the original had the right stick always set to menu, not camera. Once we regain control here, I'll double check that, though. I might be wrong. Yeah, R2, L2 or camera, yeah. Yeah, and I don't think you can change it in this one. Yeah, no. No, you can't in this one. And this, so in the new ones, you can use right stick as camera if you want, of course, in the remakes. But in the original one here, right stick is always command menu. There's no way to change that. Which, I don't know. I'm not against, but it also just takes a little bit of getting used to after being so used to using the right stick as camera for so long. Oh, yeah, soon shit will go down. Rue, you've never played Kingdom Hearts, have you? You played a little bit of Birth by Sleep, and that's it? They changed that in Final Mix? Oh, it was Final Mix, not the remaster? I thought it was the remaster they saved it for, but you're probably right. I don't think I ever played the original Kingdom Hearts Final Mix. It's been so long that I forget. I did do Kingdom Hearts 2 Final Mix, though. I've talked about that before. I had to look up translation guides and stuff online so I knew what all of the different items were. It was a massive pain in the ass, but but I got there in the end, man. That was huge for me as a kid. Just because in that game, they actually added new stuff. Whereas in... Oh, that's right. Can't collect water till we talk to Kyrie once. Whereas in Kingdom Hearts 1, the final mix didn't change that much. Finished Birth by Sleep, never played another one because you were scared by what happened to Terra. I mean, I still think you should play the other ones, dude. The Terra incident is Kingdom Hearts Birth by Sleep, like, exclusive. Terra's not really in the other games until you get to 3, so... Or 0.2 Birth by Sleep, I guess they probably talk about him. I don't think they talk about him in 2 at all. Not that I remember, at least. But my memory's pretty shit, so who knows? It's the point he doesn't get his body back. I mean, look, it was for the greater good and all that BS, though, right? Like, also, touching little scene. Kid Kyrie and Kid Sora drew each other on the rocks. And then, oh yeah, there is Lingering Will. You are right about that. And now, slightly older Kid Sora is drawing them, sharing the Powpoo fruit together.
Well, who's there?
I've come to see the door to this world.
Worst model of the entire game, this dude.
This world has been connected.
I didn't even think that was a person for a long time. Like, that looks like some sort of mushroom dude or something. I don't know.
Soon to be completely eclipsed.
Well, whoever you are, stop freaking me out like this. Huh? Well, where did you come from?
You do not yet know what lies beyond the door.
So you're from another world.
There is so very much to learn. You understand so little.
Oh yeah? Well, you'll see. I'm gonna get out and learn what's out there.
A meaningless effort. One who knows nothing can understand nothing.
So who's the hooded dude? He's... Take a wild guess. He's the big bad of every Kingdom Hearts game. Specifically in this one, I guess. I mean, I don't want to spoil anything. So I don't know if I should actually say. But, like, there's basically one group of baddies for the entire Kingdom Hearts games. Besides, like, the world-specific stuff. Nothing really out of the ordinary. How did he get here? Yeah, just a random door in a cave that we can't seem to go through. Nothing out of the ordinary. Perfectly normal. Just kills me, man. Like, how do they not ask more questions about that random door in a cave? Like, that just trips me the hell out. If I was growing up and just started exploring a cave and there was this wooden door that I couldn't get through, like, I think I would have a couple questions, man. I don't think I would just be like, ah, whatever, it's just a door in a cave. You see these all the time. Kids be wild. Alright, so we collected all three fish. We got one coconut. We need either two or three. I can never remember how many. Now we need to get the egg, which is on top of the tree over here. That's easy enough. We got to get a couple more mushrooms and the fresh water. But we can't get the fresh water until we talk to Kyrie. These coconuts are annoying as hell. It's random when they drop. I think it's actually possible to get, like, extra coconuts too, but I've never had the patience to stand around and try to beat on them long enough to get one. Like, that's a no for me, dog. Come on, just drop a coconut. Whatever, we'll go to the coconut grove. I don't know if that's what the place is actually called, but that's what I call it. I guess we can check these trees over here, too. See if they're feeling kind today. Come on. Drop me a coconut. I can't quite see down there. Select. Oh, God, it's not inverted. Okay, I don't think any drop behind it. Nothing. Just give me a coconut. A green coconut. I admit I don't know much about coconuts, but are they actually, like, are you supposed to harvest them when they're green? Like, I'm just thinking every coconut I've seen IRL has been covered in that brown hairy husk, so, like, hey, I beat Riku, thank you.
Last time, and he whipped us all. Well, I guess Kyrie can always count on him.
How freaking rude, man. 3-on-1. Let's go. Okay, so the most annoying one, in my opinion, is the her whose name I always forget. So I'd like to try to get rid of her first. Yep. That went well. Let's try that. Let's try again, man. If I can get one or two of them out, I should be okay, but... Oh, damn it. Just gotta get one of them out of here, at least. Damn, dude. This is where I probably should use a potion, honestly. Screw it. Use it. Oh, God. Run away. Run away. Run away. Nice. One down. Okay, now I just got to get the kid here. I forget all of these characters' names, by the way. I'm terrible. I've played these kids... Oh my god. Not only. Oh my god!
Not your day, I guess.
I can't believe. I can't believe I suck so bad. We had that.
Let's get it.
Oh, I didn't re-equip a potion. If we have another potion. Oh my god, I hate you so much. Oh my god. I don't even think this run's worth using a potion on. We're doing so bad. Yeah, no.
Not your day, I guess.
It's not your day, Dick. I forgot the potion again. I'm.
You ready?
Oh my god, not having any abilities sucks. I just want to dodge, man. That's all I want in life. Well, at least every time we kill one of them, we are getting experience, so it's not for nothing. Okay, items. Sora. Exchange. Potion. Probably don't want to waste a high potion already, but I mean, look. I'm not going to say we won't. If we're having a pretty decent run and we need it, then I'm just going to use it. This is not what I would call a pretty decent run. Yeah, no.
Not your day, I guess.
Hush, child.
Let's get him.
At least these three at the end of it aren't like, ha, now it's 1 to 12. At least they don't just, like, rub it in your face like, the fight with Riku. Oh my god.
Not your day, I guess.
We're getting progressively worse as time goes on.
Let's get him!
Damn, dude. I think I'm just taking things too fast. I need to just be a little bit more chill. Damn.
Not your day, I guess.
Okay.
Let's get him.
Actually gonna focus. Getting gangbanged. I don't like it. Okay, one down. Potion. Damn, dude, come on. We beat you so easily the first time. Why do I suck so hard? Oh, my God. We walked right into it. He was stunned. I just wanted to get back over him to get a couple hits in while he was stunned.
Let's get him.
You ready?
I don't even know if we got a single hit in that time. It was not good. It was not good. That was bad.
Let's get him.
Seriously? Oh my god. Maybe we should try to take out the dude throwing shit first. I don't think that's the order I normally do it in, but he is being extra annoying. That's all right. We got this. Just gotta believe, man.
Let's
power of heart or something. Yeah. Topical. Stop running away. It's 3-on-1. What do you expect me to do? Just sit there and take it? Like... Oh, God. Oh, I think her hitting us actually knocked us out of his attack. Damn, dude.
Not your day, I guess.
I'm tired of talking to this one. We're going to the other one. One of the other ones. I think... Man, you suck at this. You do it. Come on over and show me how it's done, then.
We are going to do a little exploring today. You know, to the secret place at the base of that tree. There's gotta be something there, yeah?
Oh, there's something there, man. Some mushrooms and a weird talking dude. Just pay for the ticket over here.
Show me your stuff.
Oh wait, did I accidentally pick 1-on-1? Ah, whatever, it's experience. We talking planes, trains, or automobiles, dude? What kind of what kind of ticket? I might be able to afford a bus ticket. that's about it. Don't expect much else. You can handle a Greyhound. They have Wi-Fi. Do they really? The Greyhound buses have Wi-Fi. That's pretty dope. I didn't know that. I don't think I've ever taken a Greyhound before. I've taken trains, places, and cars, of course. But I've never taken a bus anywhere outside of like inner city buses, you know? Never done any actual traveling by bus. Tacos, let's go, man.
They say if you share it with someone you really care for, it binds you together forever and ever.
He said he wanted tacos.
It's so romantic. I gotta try it sometime.
Oh, she's going on and on about how romantic the pow-poo fruit is and shit, and then we're just like, yeah, that's cool. You want to fight?
Okay, don't hold back.
Dude, tacos actually sound really good. Noodle and I have some hamburgers. We don't have taco shells or anything, though. I mean, I have flour and butter. I guess I could just make some taco shells. Do we have seasoning? You're half expecting her to have a tail just because of her face? What? Does her face look like a animal? I'm confused. Alright. Come on back. We're gonna murder him now. All three, let's go. Probably not. We're most likely gonna lose, but we're gonna try, damn it. Her eyes, man, her eyes. You three against me.
Let's get him.
Oh my god. Already. there's just so much going on. We're so screwed. We haven't even got a hit in. So dead. Yep, caught it. I'm so mad at myself. Come on. So you think this is bad, man? I actually played this game 100% on the hardest difficulty, on proud mode, on the Final Mix remaster. You think this is a bad showing? You should have saw me playing that game. No, I don't think I'm actually all that good at Kingdom Hearts. I think I'm okay. Whereas, like, my brother, man, he sucked. No offense if he sees this or anything. But, like, I've tried to get him to play the hardest difficulties before, and he's just like, no, I'm good. I've died too many times on just the normal difficulty or the one-step-up difficulty or whatever. To even try it. And I'm like, bro, it's really not that bad. Like, you'll get used to it. You just have to, like, make sure you actually gain some levels. Don't just run past all of the enemies and ignore them and shit. Like, you actually have to fight some people to get some levels. That's all there is to it. But no, it's not for him, which, I mean, it's fine, whatever. Not everyone can be good at everything. Damn, man. I saw it coming. I wanted to dodge roll. Oh my god. Why do we suck so bad, Sora? How are you supposed to save the entire universe if you can't even beat up three little kids? Down, get her. Damn. You, Titus.
Let's get him.
You ready?
Hit in the back with a blitz ball. Couldn't remember what the hell those balls were called.
Let's get him.
Nice, more defense. Maybe we can take an extra hit. Considering we took Power of Sword, though, I'm surprised we've gotten two defense upgrades and only one attack upgrade so far.
You ready?
Dodge roll, please! Nice, nice, nice. Okay. I'm using the high potion. I don't care. Swear to God, if we die to him now, I'm gonna be so fucking mad. Oh my god, that was terrible. Oh my god, we are going to die to him. Don't do it, Sora. Okay, play it safer. Just wait, bait out an attack from him. And then hit. Come on, only a few more hits. Let's go, dude. Finally. Finally. Bragging rights. Just ignore the fact that it took three different potions and like 20 minutes to do it. Just ignore that fact. We're saving. I'm not risking like my power going out. Or the game crashing or something. I've never had the game crash before, but this is when it would happen. Seaside Shack. Let's go. Level 5. Getting the hell out of here. Alright, on to the next area. To race Riku and hopefully not lose the race. Not a huge deal if we actually do, but it feels bad, man. And where's the... So that's the fresh water source. There's a mushroom somewhere. There's one. And I think there's the one on the other side of this hill? Plateau? I don't know what the hell you call it. Lift box. Had to think for a second. Was it... if it was X or circle to pick up the box. I didn't want to break it. Square games confuse me because it, like, switches back and forth depending on the game you're playing. What's accept and what's throw. Or what's accept and what's cancel, rather. Protect chain. I probably should have grabbed that before I was fighting everyone. That would have helped. I mean, it's only one extra defense point, but hey. One might be enough to survive an extra hit or two. I don't think there's anything up here. We do still need the coconuts as well, though. Mushroom. Coconuts. Get off the tree, Sora. Nice. And then I can never remember how many coconuts we actually need. That should be enough, because we collected one earlier, too. So is that everything? I think that's everything, besides the water. Hey, have you seen Riku? Maybe. What's it to you? Oh my god. I always struggle with that jump. Oh, damn it. I didn't mean to knock that down. Rasoni's name. Let's see, how about Highwind? What would you call it? Excalibur, of course. Me? Well, Excalibur. Hey, how about the usual? Let's do it. You guys are at it again? Alright, I'll be the judge. The usual rules apply. Take any route you want. Racing to the star and back.
If I win, I'm captain. And if you win,
I get to share the Palpu with Kyrie.
Huh?
Deal? The winner gets to share a Palpu with Kyrie.
Wait a minute.
Okay, on my count.
Just screwing with his head before the big race. Oh, god damn it. I was trying to take the shortcut there. Because there's like a zip line at the top there that you can use to get over quicker, but this game does not always want to let you hop on. Oh god, I thought for sure he screwed us. Game doesn't always want to let you climb ladders nicely. It fights you on it sometimes. Also, I'm sure if, like, you do the tree part perfectly, it's faster to go up the tree or over the trees or whatever. But, like, I always find it quicker to just jump down to the bottom and just run over than to go up there. Because all those little hops take a lot of extra time from you. Pretty Stone. Man, lighten up. It's just a name, after all. What about the Palpu? What is the Pretty Stone? I don't actually remember. Pretty Stone. Has little value. Okay. I don't remember what it's for. I'm sure it does something, but I don't know. I don't remember. I don't think it's just for selling. Huh. Yeah, nope. Can't remember. Alright, Kyrie. Give me water jug, please. Today we collect provisions for our trip. Let's see, Sora, you're looking for 1 seagull egg, 3 mushrooms, 2 coconuts, 3 fish, and fill this up with drinking water, but not from the ocean. Bring everything back here. If you need help, just ask. No. I shall not. Pretty sure it's a charm, but you don't remember how. I don't remember, man. You're probably right. Are you going to need more than that? What about when you run out? No, it's fine. We're going to do some fishing and stuff while we're out there in the ocean on this little raft, dude. This, I'm making a necklace of thalassa shells. In the old days, sailors always wore thalassa shells. They were supposed to ensure a safe voyage. Thanks, Sora. I found something today, too. Here, it's yours. Hi, potion. Want to call it a day? Yeah, let's go home. I'm pretty sure that's everything. Oh yeah, how are you gonna get drinking water? See, what you do is you collect it in some sort of small tin or something, and then you put a something that's a little bit cooler over it. Put it in the direct sunlight so that you can collect the condensation. And if you're lucky, you'll get like 3 drops of water a day. Fresh, clean water from the ocean water. It's fine. 1 drop for each of them. That's all you should need. Why would you possibly need more than that?
You know, Riku has changed.
What do you mean?
Well...
You okay?
Sora, let's take the raft and go. Just the two of us.
Huh?
Just kidding.
All these kids
What's
be tripping.
What's gotten into you? You're the one that's changed, Kairi.
Maybe. You know, I was a little afraid at first. But now I'm ready. No matter where I go or what I see, I know I can always come back here. Right?
Yeah, of course.
That's good. Sora, don't ever change.
Huh?
I just can't wait. Once we set sail, it'll be great.
Cannon has all these kids at, what, like 12 years old or something like that? Honestly, I'm just surprised they thought to bring provisions, some rations with them at all, honestly. Like, I don't know, man. I remember the one time I seriously contemplated running away when I was a kid. I didn't think about grabbing any food or anything, you know? I wouldn't have made it very far under those circumstances, but yeah. Not sure why, but the stars have been blinking out one by one. There's someone with a key, the key to our survival, so I need you and Goofy to find him and stick with him. You got it? This is that letter from King Mickey, by the way, if you didn't know. We need that key, or we're doomed, so go to Traverse Town and find Leon. He'll point you in the right direction. P.S. Would you apologize to Minnie for me? Thanks, pal. Signed, King Mickey's Head.
Oh, dear. What could this mean?
It means we'll just have to trust the king.
Gosh, I sure hope he's all right.
For all of us, don't worry. We'll find the king and the
No shit, are you being for real? You took a Carmen Sandiego book? Nice. I guess if you got real desperate, you could just eat the pages, right?
Of course. You be careful now, both of you.
Oh. And to chronicle your travels, he will accompany you.
Oh, okay. Okay. Sure, yeah.
Over here.
Where in the world is Carmen Sandiego? You gotta learn to hide. That's the one to do it with.
At your service.
We hope for your safe return. Please, help the king.
Daisy really needs some hair or a bow on that crown. They're such idiots, man. Donald and Goofy, both of them.
Gorgeous.
It is true, yes. That's awesome,
your
man.
Your world disappeared, too?
Yeah, no, I left the house, and I didn't go far from the property because they started searching for me. So I hid until they left, like, to get in the car and search in a wider radius for me. And then I came out of hiding, and, like... I was real close to actually going, but it's like I said, I didn't think of packing anything. I was just like, you know, getting ready to fucking go. Like a dumbass, man. Like, I don't even know where I would have went. I guess walk to a family member's house or something. Fuck if I know. Like, I didn't have any plan or anything. I was just like, I don't want to. Basically same as like you were saying, I just didn't want to be found. At the time, if only I had a Carmen Sandiego book, maybe it would have all worked out in the end. Jiminy must be so worried about Pinocchio. That comes up. That comes up. The whole Pinocchio thing. 2 instances y'all are gonna laugh at. Wait, did you have a runaway experience as a kid too? game should not work at all, man. The story trying to be like serious and heartfelt with all of the darkness and the hearts and all that BS, right? And then you're throwing Disney characters in there. That's bad enough. But then you got dumbasses like Donald and Goofy. Just Goofy being pulled around upside down by that giant claw thing, forcing him into the gummy ship. And then this moment here, like, where they just fucking fall. Like, so dumb. Once in a bogwood forest we had behind all the townhouses where it was swampy, but not hot, and you loved it. Nana couldn't catch up, so it was easy to lose her. My sister eventually caught me, though. Nice. Nice. We had a small swamp on our property, and one of my favorite things as a kid, we had a rope tied to the tree that, like, overhung it because it was down in this little valley, and you would just grab that rope and do a running jump off the cliff, and the rope would, like, swing you back around. Wait. It was a ton of fun. Once as a kid. And if you fell, it wasn't that big of a deal. So while it was a decent drop, it was all soft swamp and reeds and shit underneath, so.
Storm? Oh, no!
Yeah, there you go. See, you can see the island off in the distance. Like, they live on one island, and then they take a boat to go to the island where all they play.
Come on down.
So Chocobo's the whole thing there with, like, why didn't they just... That's actually a really good point. Why the hell didn't they just fashion a sail for one of those rowboats and just take that? Work a hell of a lot better than the raft they had. Hell, they could have tied two or three of the rowboats together and had some extra space for storage for the rations.
What's that? Riku's boat and Kairi's.
How can you tell whose boats those are? They look exactly the same as all the other ones. Oh shit, why am I... Stop. I don't know why I'm trying to hit these things. This dinky little wooden sword, as I mentioned before, doesn't do shit to the Heartless. Better go find Riku first. Okay. I don't quite remember the order of events. Riku, my guy. How you feeling, bro? You doing okay over there? Brooding on your little island on the island?
Where's Kairi? I thought she was with you.
The door.
Oh, yeah, they even have their own boats. Dude, I... God, I'm stupid. I didn't put that together either.
Now we can
That's
go to
literally
the
their
world.
Own boats.
What are you talking about? We gotta find Kairi.
This whole intro makes so much less sense now.
Once we step through, we might not be able to come back. We may never see our parents again. There's no turning back. But this may be our only chance. We can't let fear stop us. I'm not afraid of the darkness.
You should be.
Riku.
You're mad at your Nana? You lived with your aunt, who apparently pushed you down the stairs once, but you don't remember that? Holy fuck, dude. Glad you don't anymore. You grabbed your coat and bear and went out on a walk. I love that you grabbed your bear. That's something that Noodle would do, dude. If she ever tried to run away from home, I don't know if she ever did as a kid or not, but I 100% I would expect her to grab her bear on her way out. Like, I feel like Terra caused this partially because he decided to give the power to him. Spoiler alert! Holy hell! No, I mean, I know all of the... I've played every Kingdom Hearts games besides Kingdom Cross Key, whatever the hell the mobile one's called. I never played that one, but I did watch through the major story beats on the Kingdom Hearts... Was it the 1.5, 2.5 collection that had all the stories for that? I think it was 2.5 specifically. But anyways. So no worries about spoiling anything for me, but you might spoil some things for random people. Red Eye will be buried with you? Yeah, same for Noodles Bear. Bedtime Bear. 100% that thing's probably gonna end up being buried with her. She never goes anywhere without it, if she can help it. She's only... like slept somewhere without it a couple of times since we've been together, and that's just because she was like in a rush to leave or whatever and forgot to grab it. It wasn't by choice, and she was upset, very upset by the fact that she that she did so. Oh yeah, sorry, it's fine, man. Look, we may end up playing through the other Kingdom Hearts games at some point. But, like, it's fine, dude. Everyone here right now, besides maybe Nate, knows the full story for Kingdom Hearts. And if there's any, like, random people here, I guess, then they may or may not. But, like, I do. I know Chocobo does. You obviously know anything you're saying, so, like...
Sora...
There you go. Nate said he knows most of it, so... Yeah, it's not like you're really spoiling much for us. Imagine she couldn't sleep without it. Even if you don't hold him, he's always next to me on your pillow. Yeah. That's how Noodle is, dude. She usually, like, sleeps on him. Of course, throughout the, like, rest her head on him. Of course, throughout, like, the night, he ends up beside her or on the floor right next to the bed or something like that. But she always goes to sleep with him at least. I love how just beating this dude's hand a million times somehow murders him. That makes total sense. I would like that health that you dropped, please. Thank you. It's actually kind of helpful that this dude spawns little heartless friends, because, yeah, health orbs for us, man. Although he went down a lot easier than I expected. I guess I'm just used to playing on Proud. And I think whenever I did my Proud mode completion run, I think I may have won Shield. Because I was worried about, you know, dying too easily with all of the extra difficulty shit. But I don't remember. That was probably... Did I do that? I'm pretty sure I did that on the PS3 version. Probably like 5 years ago at this point or something. Maybe six.
Whoa. Look! A storm's going out!
Come on, let's hurry!
Wonder what world just disappeared. Donald basically telling Goofy he's a dumbass, and Goofy just being like, yeah, you're probably right, dude. I am pretty stupid, after all. But we could have skipped this entire section had they just listened to Pluto. Or Goofy, rather.
What a dream.
This isn't a dream.
Do you know where we are? Hey!
Isn't Goofy a dog? If so, how come Pluto is more dog than Goofy? Yeah, that's always the question, ain't it? But is Goofy meant to be a dog, or is he meant to be a cow? Like, because that's what's his name's meant to be, right? Although not, I don't. Pete? Is Pete meant to be a cow? I don't remember. Anyways, but yeah, no, that is a weird thing about the about Disney. You have your animals that are anthropomorphic, and then you have their pets, which are also animals, but for some reason can't talk. I don't, it's whatever. It's Disney. It's a cartoon. You just learn to ignore it. Got our first postcard. Hello, children. Welcome. Are you looking to buy, or maybe have you something to sell? I'm here to shop. I want to sell. Stock. So the pretty stone. I'm gonna keep a hold of it. Is it just used for... I wonder if it's just used for crafting. I really don't remember what that's used for. We're probably fine on potions and things. We only have a couple, but honestly, that should be fine. Charge keeping the shops clean. It's easier than our bedrooms. We're going to earn enough money here to go on our own adventure. Good luck. All Pluto needs to do is wear pants once. He puts on the pants, suddenly stands up straight, gets a voice. I can dig it. People with nowhere else to turn to come to this town. Where am I from? That's none of your business. Don't ask that question here. Everyone's got an unhappy past. Hey, Dewey and Louie, the little shits, yeah. And they continue to be little shits. Keep seeing new faces today. An odd pair walked by just a while ago. Wonder who that could be. By the way, I see the chest in the back of that little shop area. I'm not ignoring it. Just can't open it right now. Seeing all of this town will take some time, Kupo, especially for newcomers. Even if you can't go to certain areas now, you'll be able to go later. This town is divided into three districts. This is the first district. And we can't go into the other ones yet. I fully admit I don't remember where all of the postcards are. I remember where a small handful are. But I don't remember all of them. But yeah, see? It's locked. You have to, if I remember correctly, you have to put out all these candles to get it to open. Pretty sure that's how it works. Hello, Leon. We have, what, probably no money right now, so... Hey there, how can I... Ah, oh, it's only a kid. I'm not a kid. In the name Sora, you're like 12 years old. You're a kid. So why the long face, Sora? You lost or something? No? Well, maybe. Where are we? Traverse Town. So Gramps, is this really another world? Don't call me Gramps. The name's Sid. Oh, I said Leon. I'm an idiot. Anyway, not sure what you're talking about, but this sure ain't your island. Guess I better start looking for Riku and Kairi. Good luck with whatever it is you're doing. If you ever run into trouble, you can come to me. I'll look out for you. Thanks, old man. Mithril Shard, very nice. Yeah, it has the same symbol as the Pretty Stone, so yeah. It must be used for the crafting system. I didn't actually check. Do we have any money? No, we are completely broke, so we're not buying anything right now. We'll come back to the save point later. Trying to use the right stick for, whatchamacallit, for the camera controls. It's not working out too well. I don't think... Ah, it is possible. Wow. I've always done this in such a harder, like, roundabout way, getting this chest. I did not realize you could just push that box over here and do it. I always, like, hopped up on the other side of it over... Hold on, let me go up and around. But the other side of the roof, and then, like, made my way around that way, or waited until we had, like, the glide or something, and did it that way. Always, like, come over here, hopped up on this, and then from here... like jumped over to here and then from here jumped to there. That's how I always got that stupid chest. I didn't realize you could just push that one big crate over and use that to get right up here, no problem. Super easy. Like, this is the item workshop, Koopa. We're researching item synthesis and super weapon forging. Super weapon forging, that's my kind of stuff. Find whatever items you need at the nephew's shop. Okay. That's not traumatizing or anything. watching a dude die and his heart be stolen right in front of you, turning into a creature that now is going to try and murder you. It's perfectly normal. Nothing to worry about, man. Just keep running around, Sora. Ow. Get wrecked. And that's why we didn't buy any potions. Ow. Noise, noise. Okay, correct order of operations. We go from there into here. I'm gonna try and remember. I'll probably screw it up. But I vaguely remember. From there to here, and then run to the end of the hallway. Go down this side. And then through the clock tower interior. Where did he go? Did he fall off the... whatever. Gizmo shop, that's what they call it. And then this part always tripped me up as a kid, man, because it took me so long to get Donald and Goofy to, like, actually finally run into me. Way longer than I would like to admit, but it was a while. Now four. Each time you kill this group, by the way, another one spawns, in case that wasn't clear. Like, one more spawns. Starts with one, and then two, and then three, so on. Until, finally, you murder them all. You don't have to fight them all or anything like that. I'm just doing it for the extra experience points, so we're gonna need it. The money's nice, too. You might be able to buy an accessory or something. Give ourselves a little bit more defense. Ow, you dick. Noise, noise. I think there's one more group. I think this is the last group. I could be wrong, though. I remember as a kid, one of the revelations that I had once I got older was that the longer combos aren't always necessarily better. Like, in the Kingdom Hearts series, you often get equipables that let you, or abilities that let you extend your combo length. Which I thought, you know, is better. I couldn't see any reason why it wouldn't be. But it turns out the finishing moves of combos are super strong. So for some enemies, and in some situations, it is much better to actually keep a short combo, like the three-hitter that we have here at the beginning of the game, than it is to have a super long combo. Because the problem with, like, the finishing move is that it has, like, all the knockback or whatever. You can't get as many hits in. It doesn't stun them for as long or whatever. But the damage output just ends up being well worth it. Plus, a lot of Kingdom Hearts games use, like, a revenge value thing. The more hits you get in on somebody in a short amount of time, the more likely they are to do certain attacks that just kind of screw you and things like that. So, the mechanics of the game go surprisingly deep if you know what you're doing or spend the time to learn them. Of course, if you don't want to, you don't have to. You can just wail on things for long periods of time until they die. Kind of wobbly. Guess I can't climb it. Well, fine then. I'll go in this door right here. Not here either. This could take a while. And I assure you, as a child, it did. Oh boy, did it. 99 puppies were lost amid the chaos of the world's destruction. Find them in various worlds. Okay. getting all 99 Dalmatians was a giant pain in the ass as a kid, too. I don't know if I ever finished it when I was younger. Just so many chests, man. Random-ass places they're hidden at. Come back. Thank you. One of the things that I'll always be upset is that they removed the trendy commands. We can't actually use them yet, but if you've been paying attention, you may see every once in a while little symbols on the ground that are different colors. And those are trendy commands where the group, all three of them, can get together to do something to interact with the environment. Like, they can all stomp on the ground or in the case of, like, that bar there, I think they all push against it, like, charge against it or something like that, to knock it over. Little things like that, and it opens up new areas or collectibles or whatever the case may be. I always found it weird that they got rid of it. It was a nice little system. As you leveled up, you could revisit worlds and just get more stuff that you couldn't get before. Kind of added a bit of a Metroidvania element to it, I suppose. Should be another spawn of enemies right here somewhere. Maybe it's at the end of the hallway? Huh. Yeah, there it is. I say, I knew there was a third group in here. I don't know if it's actually possible or not. But I spent so much time as a kid trying to get around this stack of boxes to get that chest back there before I had the proper trendy command to do it. Never succeeded, but I'll be damned if I didn't try. Alright, through the door. And then, here's the thing. After we go in this door, this is the part that I think tripped me up as a kid. We're going to go ahead and kill these for the experience, but then we're just going to turn around, and we're going to go right back in that door we just came out of. And that should trigger the next cutscene, yeah. Leon, Mr. Leon, where are you? He's hiding. He wants nothing to do with you. And then back out again. And then back to the main part of town? I think. Fuck, your hands are cold. Why are your hands so cold, bro? Do you have, like, bad circulation in your hands or something? One of the guys at work was complaining about having, like, super cold hands the other day. And I mentioned that, you know, it might just be bad circulation. And then he was like, I don't know, I don't think it's that bad or anything. I said, well, like, hold your hand out. And he did. And instantly I was like, dude, I think you have some bad circulation. He's like, wait, what do you mean? And his fingernails were white. Which, if you don't know, with good circulation, when you put your hand out, as long as it's not, like, stretched out hard, just loosely held out, your fingernails should be mostly, you know, pinkish. His were just, like, super white. One of the things that I've read to check for circulation in your hands is that, like, you take your fingernail, you press on, it'll turn white, you let go, and it should relatively quickly turn back to pink, because that's the blood flowing back into your finger after you let go or whatever. So if your fingers are just already white, then it's like, bruh, I don't think you have blood in your hands. That's probably why your hands are so fucking cold, my guy. It was like 2 days ago. The dude is diabetic, so it probably is related to that. I don't know if it's common for them to have problems with circulation to their hands or not, but I know it's pretty common for people with advanced diabetes to have problems with circulation to their feet. If yours could be because you're pre-diabetic, I mean, I'm obviously not a doctor, just a dude on the internet, standard disclaimer there, but I don't think it causes much circulation issues until it gets, you know, worse. But I could be wrong there. 100% could be wrong on that. Still haven't found him. Keep your chin up. Take another look around town. What do you need? I'm here to shop, my guy. Can we afford anything yet? Leon does use some fire attacks. I'm pretty sure his gun blade thing counts as a fire attack. But we don't have enough money for any of this shit anyways, so I'm just gonna ignore it. I hope you're wrong. Wait, what? Oh, because of the circulation issues that you've had in the past? I mean, look, there can be plenty of causes for circulation issues. It doesn't have to be diabetes, but I mean, you do have a history of sugar consumption. Abnormal sugar consumption, so who knows, my guy.
As long as you continue to wield the Keyblade. But why? Why would it choose a kid like you?
Hey! What's that supposed to mean?
Never mind. Now, let's see that Keyblade.
What? There's no way you're getting this.
All right. Then have it your way.
I'm gonna try to beat Leon here, but I don't expect to. And you don't have to. If you do, you get like an extra item or something like that. Whereas, if you lose, the story just progresses as normal. I would really like him to come down here, too, where it's a little bit more open. Ow. I have beaten him before by doing, like, save reloading or soft resetting. But it's legitimately a hard fight for this early in the game. At least for me. I'm sure there's people that can do it no problem, but,
hey, you
yeah.
found it. Nice going, Leon.
Does she look familiar to anyone?
It looks like things are
worse. Hint, we saw her last night on stream.
A lot worse.
Is that fucking Wu-Tai girl? Yes, it is. Her name's Yuffie, by the way. But yeah, that's Wu-Tai girl.
Actually, I'm not scared.
Excuse me. Did the king send you?
There's Aerith! Oh, Aerith. At least in this universe, she gets to live. Sorry,
on,
spoilers for
bum.
A 20-year-old
Wake
game.
You okay?
I guess.
Those creatures that attacked
over 20
you
years
after
old, actually.
The Keyblade. But it's your heart they really want, because you wield the Keyblade.
I'm so glad that you're okay, Kairi.
Kairi? Who are you talking about? I'm the great Ninja Yuffie.
Hmm?
I think you might have overdone it, Squall.
That's Leon.
The Keyblade.
Yeah, we had to get it away from you to shake off those creatures. It turns out, that's how they were tracking you.
It was the only way to conceal your heart from them. But it won't work for long. Still, hard to believe that you, of all people, are the chosen one.
Having played Final Fantasy VIII now, I still don't understand why they chose Leon instead of Cloud. I guess because he's a little bit more of like a leader type compared to Cloud. Cloud's more of the dark brooding type, but like,
you know, there are many other worlds.
They have Yuffie and Aerith both from Final Fantasy VII, but then they paired them with Leon, like from Final Fantasy VIII.
They've been secret because they've never been connected until now. When the Heartless came, everything changed.
The Heartless?
The ones who attacked you, you remember?
Those without hearts.
The darkness in people's hearts. That's what attracts them.
And there is darkness within every heart.
Hey, have you heard of someone named Ansem?
I am Sam?
Ansem.
He was
never heard of him.
The Heartless. He recorded all of his findings in a very detailed report.
Gorsh, can we see it?
Its pages are scattered everywhere.
Scattered?
too many worlds.
Oh, then maybe the king went to find them.
Yes, those were my thoughts exactly.
We've got to find him quick.
Red! Plus we need that key.
That's right. The Keyblade.
So, this is the key.
Exactly.
The Heartless have great fear of the Keyblade. That's why they'll keep coming after you, no matter what.
Well, I didn't ask for this.
The Keyblade chooses its master, and it chose you.
So, tough luck.
How did all this happen? I remember being in my room. Wait a minute! What happened to my home? My island? Riku!
Is gone, kid.
You know what? I really don't know.
Alright, we are going to do a save and take a quick break, because we skipped the last break, and your boys really gotta pee. So we're not skipping again, damn it. Gonna save the game, though. You always like the Squall Yuffie team up? I just find it weird because, like, they had the choice of Cloud. But, I mean, their characters fit together, I guess. It's just, like, I don't know. It's just weird. Like, why would they have Aerith, Yuffie, and Squall, but then have Cloud, like, show up later? It's just, I don't know. It just always kind of confused me, I guess. But I do think Squall Leon is the better pick for the intro to the game, you know? Like, exactly, because that's what Cloud would be doing. He wouldn't be leading, trying to fix this stuff. He would be brooding somewhere, like, which is exactly why I think they made the right choice. It just feels weird to me still. Dude, stop holding it in. I'm working on it. I'm going now. So yeah, we're gonna go ahead and take a quick break, guys. I'll be back in just a couple of minutes. Probably 3 to 5, probably closer to 5. Now's a good time to stand up, stretch, get a drink, do all that stuff as well, if you haven't done it recently. To me. So, I think you're alright, man. Yeah, maybe something with your connection issues that you're having. Maybe it's showing too because of that, I don't know. But yeah, no worries. No problems on this end. Yeah, I really hope that, like, if they do a remaster of 2 or something like that and bring it to PC, that would be amazing. Just because I have no idea when it'll be that I finally end up picking up an Xbox console. Well, actually, to be fair, I do actually own a couple Xbox 360s. They just need some work done on them to get them working again, basically. So once I get one of them fixed, I could just play Fable 2 on there if I ever wanted to. Oop. Which is something maybe I'll do. How many of the Ratchet and Clank games have you played, Nate? Just the first one, or have you ever played like the second, third, etc., etc.? The first one's the only one that I've played through to completion. Well, no, that I don't think that's true. Actually, I'm pretty sure I've played the second. And maybe the third one to completion. I remember that I played more than one of them, at least when I was a kid. I just don't remember how far I got in the other ones. The first one I've definitely beaten, for sure. But it was so long ago since I played through them that I don't remember all of them that I've done. It's so weird. I just played this, like I mentioned before, for the podcast not too long ago. And in my time playing it for that, I unlocked a lot more of the new movement abilities and stuff like that. So going back now to not having any of the hover, or anything like that, just feels really weird. Fable 2 had the best DLC, and you played each that was on PS2, but never beat any of them. Didn't have a memory card for the longest time. Oh, yeah, you've mentioned that before. That sucks, man. Played all of them, but never got to beat them. At least on the PS2. That's insane.
Look, plumber's crack.
What did you just say?
I said, look, the plumber's back.
All right, wise guy. Shouldn't you be on one of them escape transports?
Escape transports?
Newsflash, giant robots attacking. The escape transports are taking all the rich folks off this god-darn planet.
So why aren't you on one?
Socioeconomic disparity.
What?
He hasn't got enough bolts.
Working people have to wait for Captain Quark to save us.
Well, got anything worth a lot of bolts?
I got this thing. Shows two weirdos ditching their ship. It's got coordinates to a desert planet, too.
An infobot. Ratchet, we could use that.
500 bolts. Thankfully, we've been collecting all the bolts that we can find, so. We'll take it.
Geronimo!
And then he just penguins down the sewer pipe.
Mayday, mayday. This is the solar ship Radical. We seem to be under attack from the planet's surface.
Relax, kid. It looks like some sort of fireworks display. Probably in your honor.
Whoa! That was close. Ah!
Pipe down, I can't concentrate.
Oh, we've been hit!
An unexpected detour. When we land, I'll see if I can scare up an exhibition for you.
We're not gonna live that long.
Kid, let's M-scream!
Eject! Eject!
Wow, sucks to suck, man. Getting hit like that.
You see that guy on the left? That was Skid McMarks.
Does he know Captain Quark?
I doubt it. He's a Skid pro McMarks, hoverboarder. Hmm? Always going off about how cool he is.
Looks like he's in trouble.
I'll say. I've never seen him look so freaked out.
Gadgetron Infobots give
and it
you
says yeah, so someone
planets.
Turn
now
that down
you
a bit.
Have the Infobot for planet Iridia, you'll need to find.
Yeah, so if someone turned off the power or if it went off, which happened a lot where you lived. You lost all your progress. That is rough, man. I kind of feel your pain because when I first got, we're gonna turn subtitles on, by the way. When I first got a PS2, my mom brought it home with the Sly Cooper game. It's a story I've told before, but she didn't know that you needed a memory card, which is fair. We were mostly a Nintendo household up until that point. My brothers had a PlayStation 1, but we didn't have a whole lot of games for it or anything. Whereas like I, growing up, just had an original Nintendo and then would rent like a N64 and whatnot. Eventually I got a Sega Genesis as well, but with all the cartridge-based games, there either wasn't any save files, right? You just use passwords, or the game saved directly on the cartridge. So she had no idea that she really needed a memory card. So she just brought me home Sly Cooper and the PS2 itself. And, yeah, I played it for a little bit and then realized that there was no way for me to save the game. And, well, I told her about the problem, and it wasn't too long after that. I don't remember how long exactly or anything, but it wasn't too long after that that she brought me home a memory card. So, I kind of feel your pain there. Said, heck, when you were trying to beat Guitar Hero 2, the system was hot enough you couldn't make us more on it. Oh, man. That's crazy. At least with the Guitar Hero games, they always had the cheats. If you had internet to look them up or whatever, you could look up the cheats on how to unlock all songs and stuff like that. Because while I have beaten all of the Guitar Hero games before, we still use the cheats a fair bit. Because anytime you'd go to a friend's house, if they didn't have them all unlocked, or if you just... Alright, I'm back. Got a mug of water while I was downstairs too, because my thermos is empty. Just plain water this time, nothing fancy. I think I have a little bit of water flavorant around here somewhere, but I don't remember where. I might have finished it. So, oh well, doesn't matter.
Water's good.
I do enjoy a nice glass of water every now and then. I do prefer room temperature, though. Noodle thinks I'm weird for it. I guess, really, her whole family kind of thinks I'm weird for it, but... I prefer room temperature water. I think it's because I had sensitive teeth growing up. So I didn't really like drinking super cold water because it would hurt my mouth. So I just kind of got used to the flavor of room temperature, and now that's what I prefer, my go-to. I've heard that the Keyblade can open all sorts of locks. Give it a try the next time you find a treasure chest or door locked. You mean like this one? Shit. X, not circle. Hey, elixir! Let's go! Examine. Bald Mountain, 7 a.m. Midday Jungle. I know there's another puzzle. I don't know if we can do the puzzle in these rooms now, but I do remember there is some kind of puzzle. I just don't remember how it works. And it may not be this room exactly, but in this set of hotel rooms here. Sooner or later, the Heartness will find you. You'd best prepare yourself. Prepare myself? To fight for your life. Are you ready? I'm ready. Yuffie, let's go join Aerith. She should be there by now with the other visitors.
Leon, look! Ah!
No!
God damn it.
Yuffie!
Bye-bye, Donald.
Sora, let's go.
It was nice knowing you while you lasted, my guy. Goofy just watching him get smashed, doesn't even care. Don't bother with the small fry, find the leader. Let's go. You say that and all, but I'm gonna bother with the small fry because experience points. I hate when they fall down and I can't hit them anymore. Get back here. Hey, another level up. That'll come in handy for the boss fight that's coming up. Okay, we're going to Third District now. Had to think for a second. I think now the worst enemy in all of the Kingdom Hearts games will start spawning too. Oh, God. Potion, quickly. Okay, we actually need to be a little bit careful. I wasn't paying enough attention. We almost fucking died. But the big dudes with the bellies, and you can't hit them from the front because you just bounce off of them. I hate them with a passion. Those dudes suck so much, man. You gotta, like, get behind them or parry their attack whenever they start coming for you, one or the other. Or, I mean, you can use magic, too, but... As I mentioned before, I am really bad at magic in Kingdom Hearts, man. It's powerful. I know, like, in the speedruns, that's one of the ways they're able to deal with playing through the game super underleveled. Is by making efficient use of magic and summons and things, but I don't know. Could never get that into it. I'll take the health orbs at least, please. Ow. Okay, so it only takes like two or three hits from these guys for us to die. And in the original here, I don't know if we get the abilities Leaf Bracer or what's the other one? The one so you don't die the first time you fall to 1 HP or below 1 HP. Second wind, second chance, something like that. I don't remember if we get either of those abilities in this one or not. Those ones are lifesavers, especially for like the Sephiroth fight, man. Because that dude can straight up murder you in one or two hits, even when you're max level. It is insane. And then the Leaf Bracer lets you, whenever you're healing, you don't take damage. Which is also a huge boon. Nothing's worse than like trying to heal yourself, pop a cure real quick, and then somebody smacks you and takes your last HP from you.
Gosh, are these the Heartless guys?
Let's go get them, Goofy!
Good intro. That's how you form a lifelong bond right there. Okay, at least the big belly drum dudes haven't actually started spawning yet. I must have misremembered when they start spawning. Donald's already almost dead. No surprise there. That dude sucks. All right.
Come on.
Run away. Bye, Donald. Should probably try to take care of the feet first, honestly. They're a lot easier to hit. But the hands are more annoying, I feel like. Ow. We actually blocked that or parried that? That was pure luck, man. Lock back onto the hand. Stop wasting all your heals on Donald. Save your heals for me. I'm the one that needs heals. Aw, damn it. What did I just tell you? I said I'm the one that needs heals. Son of a bitch. It's fine. We'll go again. I should have been mashing triangle trying to force a heal on myself is what I should have done once I got down to like half HP there. I should also probably... Do we have any equipment? No, okay. But we should have some extra items at least. Exchange. And high potion. There. There we go. Oh. Wait, is there no cuts? There's no cutscene skips in this version. Oh, that sucks. All right. Well, hopefully we don't die too many times with this boss. We might see this cutscene a couple times. Too bad we don't have the opportunity to, like, equip them with any potions or anything. I mean, they obviously come pre-equipped with some. Hence, Goofy constantly healing Donald. Well, that went quicker than last time. I feel like the original Kingdom Hearts games, 1 and 2, were a lot harder than 3, by the way. They changed a lot for 3. I still enjoyed the game, but Kingdom Hearts 2, I forever think will probably be the best. And then Kingdom Hearts Birth by Sleep and 1 are close seconds. Kingdom Hearts 3 is, besides the spin-off games and... Somebody heal me, please. Or not. Why? I mashed triangle. They suck. But yeah. Kingdom Hearts 3, man. Like, just the whole... The way combat feels, it's like... It feels a bit floaty. And, like, the hardest difficulty on it just gets to be a little bit of a grind fest trying to kill things. They got rid of the form system from 2, which was super cool. One of my favorite things about 2. Something a lot of people really liked was being able to switch forms. The dark mode. Man, that's another thing I used to use the code breaker for, was to just give us, like, unlimited dark mode. I forget what the form was actually called, which was originally just a random chance in 2, based off of, like, a value of how many times you've used your form ability before and stuff like that. You basically became a Heartless, and you were super strong and super, super fast and agile, but you couldn't use any items or magic at all. So that was like that's how they balanced it. But, in 3 though, I was on normal mode. I only died one time. in the entire game. I would have died one other time, but I had an auto revive item equipped. But like, just looking at this now, or no, I wasn't on normal. I was on the hardest difficulty that was available at the time. They added a harder difficulty. That's why I was confused. Anyways, point is, I only died once in the entire game. And you can see here, we've only made it, what, 2 hours into the game? Not even actually 2 hours into the game. We've only played for 2 hours total. And we have died a good few handfuls of times. Yeah, these guys are refusing to heal me. I don't know. Are they refusing to heal me because, like, are they just programmed not to until you actually become, like, a proper party or something? I'm very confused why they're not healing at all. Me, rather. I have no problem healing each other. Okay, I wanna get away. This is why I wanna get away. I saw it coming, I tried to parry. We need to make sure to equip another potion. Because it didn't save our equips in between runs. Items, high potion exchange. Sora, there. Potion exchange, Sora, there. I very much miss not only the ability to skip cutscenes, but also the ability to have it automatically re-equip items once you use them.
Gosh, are these the heartless guys?
Let's go get them, Goofy!
All right, again, it'd be nice if we could get another protect chain like we did the first time we did this and died. We haven't gotten lucky enough to have one spawn since. Donald already died once. We haven't even gotten to the boss yet. That's one potion down from Goofy. Let's not be stingy with potions, man. We can only survive one hit. Second hit's death. Honestly, we're so low, like, max health right now that we probably should have just... Damn it. We might be able to survive one more hit. That one didn't do as much damage. But we have so low max health right now that we really should have just equipped 3 regular potions. I lied. We couldn't survive a second hit. Oh my god. Okay. You know what? We are... at pi dollar euro pound. What? I think we're gonna grind out another level real quick. I think is what we're gonna do. If we're lucky, we'll get another protect chain or something. Oh, and some Seeker of Darkness. Okay. Spirit Shard Protect Chain. Look at that, dude. Perfect timing. All right. Give me that. Maybe we'll be able to survive 2 attacks now before we die. I'm still going to grind out a level real quick, though. May not be super quick because of the option we chose at the beginning for our experience point curve, but... shouldn't take too long either. We're still super low level. Ow. Shit! God, we just suck, man. I mean, we have Huey and Louie and all them. Can we... Are the shops open? I'll stop being so stingy with the potions. Maybe we can go back and get some more. Man, that means we lost the protect chain that we got super lucky for, too. I picked a sword. I probably should have picked shield, seeing as how... Oh, fuck. I went through the door thinking we were going to District 2. It took us back here. Anyways, I picked sword. I probably should have picked shield, seeing as how it's been quite a while since I've played. And then I gave up magic because I never used magic. And I set sail at night. So I have the low experience in the beginning. Well, need more experience to level up in the beginning. Less experience overall to get to the end. To get to 99. That's just kind of my default, because normally when I'm playing the game, I'm playing to completion. I don't know for sure if we're going to do that this time or not, but yeah. So I just kind of default to that one. Honestly, I probably should have done, like, the midday one. The level curve. Maybe we'll get lucky and we'll just kill him right now with our one potion that we have equipped. Donald and Goofy refusing to heal us. And no extra levels of protect chains. We just gotta get good. And not get that stomped on. Nice parry, Goofy. Damn, dude. Yeah, we're fucked. We can't take any more hits, which I don't think is gonna happen. Oh, nice, 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 nice. Pick up some orbs, please. Please pick up orbs. Okay, I think that's enough to survive one more hit. Damn, I should have tried to parry. At least we didn't take major damage from it. Come on, destroy another piece. I need more health orbs. We're dead. Yep. I saw those feet coming. I knew we were fucked. All right. Back to grind. Which side of the door are we going to spawn on? Probably third district. Because it checkpointed when we went through the door. Yes. Okay. So go to second district. Not to third. Don't be a dumbass. Do we have, before we move, yeah, we do have a potion set at least. We don't want to die again? Yeah. If I could skip the cutscenes, it wouldn't be so bad, but watching that cutscene every single time is going to get a little bit annoying. And it's obvious we're going to need a couple extra levels anyways. Hey, Noodle, welcome back. Love, thank you for the 5 bits. Does that mean you're done with your drag show, or... Or is there just like a break in it or something? Or did it even start yet? Excuse me. Ow. Okay. Don't be stingy. Heal. Oh my god. Yeah! God, we're gonna die again. Okay. You know what? Just run away. Oh, lights. That's what you were doing. Seeing the Christmas lights. I forgot. I couldn't remember what we were doing. Or you were doing. Now we're going to the thing I try to get you to go to every year, but we never go. Are you talking about the... Where they decorate the town? That thing? Because, like, we did go that one year. And I said we could try to go this year. The only problem is we'd have to take our gas guzzler, so it costs us like $30 plus entrance fees to go there, which is super annoying, but... okay, let's just buy like 7 potions. to the stock, whatever. Damn it. It reset how many? Okay, we can carry 3. I want to keep 5. Can we afford 4 more? We can. Equip before I forget. Exchange Sora there. Exchange Sora there. I really miss the ability to automatically have it refill. I don't think we can do it in this version.
My Noodle0519 says, "Hi, stream all the steam."
Hi, Mr. Noodle0519. How are you? Get a free health refill from the save point too, and might as well save while we're here. That way we don't have to do the shopping trip again. Really wish we had either a little bit more money or get lucky on another drop on the way back. Oh, breeding session. What are we gonna get? We got... Oh, no, that was a battle, not a breed. My bad. Well, whatever. We beat up another dragon. We haven't lost yet, dude. We've gotten really lucky. I don't know if there's just a lot of streamers with really low-level dragons out there, or if we have just, like, fed ours that much that we're OP as hell. But yeah, we haven't lost yet. Oh, my God. Hit him. Jeez. Why is the battle music still going? I guess one must have, like, fell down to the bottom there or something. Oh, shit. Well, we just fell down to the bottom. Excuse me, game? Okay, never mind. I guess we're fighting these ones now. Ow. Okay. Don't be stingy. It's not circle to select. It's X. Potions are only 25 money. What was that? That's just a potion. I mean, I guess it saves us 25 bucks, but... Really hoping for another... That. Another that. Equip. More defense, please and thanks. Gonna let your phone charge for a little bit. I don't think it's going well with the stream and the GPS. Okay. Love you too. Hope you have fun out at the display they have set up. Keep pressing square trying to dodge, man. It doesn't work. We are, after we fight these two, assuming we don't die, which hopefully not, we are going to go back and save again so we don't end up having to grind for the protect chain at the very least. Because I'm half expecting to die again. Where are we sitting at for experience? Experience next level 12. Okay, so by the time we get to the next area, we'll probably level up. Oh, that's closed. Can't go that way. Save, please. After we beat this boss and get a save again, too, we're probably going to go ahead and switch on over to Pokemon. And do at least a couple rounds of Pokemon card battles. For anyone who doesn't know, Pokemon TCG Live, I'm pretty sure is the name of the app. It's free. You can download it, make an account. And, yeah, play Pokemon TCG online. It's available on everything. Mobile, PC. That's pretty much it, I guess. But, I mean, that's basically everything, right? I'm kind of surprised they didn't make a version that runs, like, on the Switch or something, to be honest. I guess they just didn't want to add, like, controller controls to it for some reason. I'm assuming when we level up, it's probably going to be an attack upgrade. I'm kind of hoping for another defense upgrade, man. I'm regretting not taking the shield in the beginning. Oh no, max HP upgrade. Okay, that's fine. I'm okay with that. Ow. That's just as good as a defense upgrade. There's so much going on, man. It's hard to keep track of all the enemies. When we can get them in groups like that, though, that's awesome. Then we can get our finisher off on all three of them at the same time. Can't wait till we get the ability to pick up orbs in a wider radius. I forgot how close you actually have to get to these things to pick them up by default. Excuse me, sir. Ah, dodge. I don't remember when we unlock the ability to dodge roll, but holy hell, I hope it's soon. The game just feels so off without it, man. If you want to give me another protect chain, that'd be cool. I can't equip it, but I can give it to Donald or Goofy. Probably Goofy. Leave him as a tank and Donald as the useless healer that he is. No luck? Oh well. Back up to full health. Perfect. I mean, it shouldn't instantly spawn us into the fight when we cross the barrier here, but I'm going to... Oh no, we're good. We have all three potions equipped. Okay, we're Gucci. Fingers crossed, dude. Here we go. Hopefully that little bit of extra HP and that protect chain give us what we need to survive.
Gosh, are these the heartless guys?
Let's go get them, Gucci!
I mean, look, if we hadn't watched this cutscene like 6 times already, I might care, but I don't. Just get it over with. Come on. Hey, Donald got a level up too. Ow. Oh no, I want to pick up the blue one. I think the blue one's the equipment. Ah, that sucks, dude. All right, I think what I normally do is go for the feet first. And I'm wondering if that's the right move. Oh, dope. We were still able to pick it up. Oh, we got out of the radius of it. I didn't think we were going to be able to. Okay, that one's already dead. Did we get a secret attack upgrade too, or are we just getting super lucky here? Maybe the game's taking pity on us because we died so many times. Is that another piece down? Holy shit, dude. Oh, god damn it. Okay. Nice, and they actually healed me this time. I mean, they both did it, which was kind of pointless. I'm gonna take a hit again. Okay, either they don't have any potions left or they don't want to use it. I'm using my own. I don't really want to attack that. I want to attack the feet. Why'd you heal Donald? I'm the one dying over here. Oh, God. Oh, God. I saw the feet coming. I was so scared, dude. Okay. Damn, dude. Please, just... Please. Come on, man. The feet have got to be about dead. Okay. They reformed. Okay, he's doing his little hop. Nope. Focus on the feet. Nice, nice, nice. Ow. Ow, ow, ow. I need health pickups, please. Foot. Attack the foot. Nice. Okay. Pick up the health. Let's go, dude. We got it. We have no heals left, which really sucks, but... Nice. There we go, dude. We got the combo plus, which is fine. Except I'm not as big of a fan of combo plus as I was when I was younger. And more defense, again. With taking the sword, dude, we sure are getting a lot of defensive upgrades. Brave Warrior. I'll take it.
So, you were looking for me?
They too have been seeking the wielder of the Keyblade.
Hey, why don't you come with us? We can go to other worlds on our vessel.
I wonder if I could find Riku and Kairi.
You're not gonna find them sitting around here, my guy.
Are you sure?
Who knows? But we need them to come with us to help us find the king.
Sora, go with them. Especially if you want to find your friends.
Yeah, I guess.
But you can't come along looking like that. Understand?
Ooh.
No frowning, no sad face, okay?
Yeah, you gotta look funny. Like us.
Yes, but one's like fucking goofy, dude. Faces.
Happy?
I'm literally shaking my head. They're all a bunch of dumbasses. All three of them.
Okay, why not? I'll go with you guys.
Lame's Goofy.
And meanies? How are they? I don't really consider them to be mean. But they are all a bunch of dumbasses, that's for sure. I mean, they might be a little bit mean to Goofy sometimes, but you know what? Like, he deserves it. Let's be honest.
That little squirt took down that Heartless. Who'd have thought it? Such is the power of the Keyblade. The child's.
Oh no, it's so dark in here. I wonder who these people are.
Why don't we turn him into a Heartless? That'll settle things quick enough.
And the brat's friends are the king's lackeys. Slug on the eyes, they're all bilge rats by the look of them.
You're no prize yourself.
Shut up!
Enough! The Keyblade has chosen him. Will it be he who conquers the darkness? Or will the darkness...
Hades, Jafar, Ursula, Hook, Maleficent, Boogie... Yep.
Way,
I mean, no. It's way too dark. There's no way you could tell who those people were. It's a secret. You'll find out later. Totally not obvious. You're taking guesses? I mean, fair. Fair. I don't know about the Hook. Just pick one at random. That's definitely not Hook, man. That's Hook's brother, Book. He has a book for a hand. It's just an oddly shaped book. Like a J. It's weird. Make sure you're prepared for the journey ahead of you. We don't know how far the Heartless have spread. Check out the shops here. They've got some pretty neat stuff. This is from all of us. $100? Let's go, dude. That's enough to buy 4 potions. Hope you find your friends. Look out for each other. Keep your spirits up. Gummy ship is outside that gate. Pan camera. The what? That's our ship. Wait till you see it. Hold on, Sora, this is for you. Power of fire, let's go. Select magic to cast spells, either refill MP. Goofy, give him that other thing. The what? You know. Oh, yeah. Dodge roll. Hell yeah, dude. Oh, thank fuck. I'm seriously, that's all I wanted in life. Guess we should look for him along the way. Okay, is that it? Let's get going. Not till we're ready. Well, I see big adventures coming their way. Looks like it's up to me to keep track of all of it in my journal. Now, before we forget, dodge roll, equip. Combo plus, whatever, dodge roll. That's all we need, dude. We'll equip everything for Goofy. Donald has no abilities yet. Equipment. Brave Warrior increases strength and max HP. You know what? I'm gonna keep my protect chains. I'm gonna give that to Goofy. And the protect chain. Donald's gonna die no matter what anyways, so just screw that guy. And then items. I used all my potions. So let's... Oh, shoot. No. No. Son of a bitch. Exchange stock. Potion. Potion. Potion for me. Can we, before I give stuff to them, can I? Yes, good. I can change this. Okay. So for Donald, I want you to do regular attacks only occasionally. Offensive magic only occasionally. Defensive magic constantly. Heal us. That's what I care about most with you, my guy. Special magic is fine. HP items frequently. MP items only in emergency. I think perform melee attacks, attack magic. Okay. Yeah, I think that's good. Although maybe advanced magic should only be occasionally too, honestly. Mostly defensive magic and heal with whatever. I'd rather you use heals first before you use items. But yeah. And then Goofy, yours is going to be a little bit more normal. You're going to do regular attacks frequently, special attacks constantly, shield techniques constantly. That's all fine. Support actions, though. Actually, you know what? I lied. We're going to take these down to frequently. Support actions more often. More defensive. Yeah, I think we'll... Something like that. We'll put those on constantly, too. That looks good enough. And then triangles are fire. Gotcha. What color Trinity do we get from the get-go? Is it blue? Hey, look at this mark. I wonder what it is. It's a Trinity mark. They appear in many places. Only the blue ones react in the beginning. Sora, Donald, and Goofy can perform various Trinity moves besides... By these marks? Whatever. Trinity. And chest. I think it's a postcard. Yeah. Go ahead and turn that in. We have two postcards to turn in now, actually. Is there anything else we want to do? I guess we could do Merlin's thing, like open him up, but I don't really think it matters right now. We can light the fire in here using our magic.
Fire!
There we go. Can I turn the camera, please? Oh, it's because I was locked on. That's why I wouldn't let it turn. Does that do anything? I know smoke actually comes out of the ceiling now once we do that, but I don't remember if it gives us, like, a postcard or something, maybe? Because it's been a while. I don't remember the location of them all. Might as well do it the easy way now that I know it works. I think it may have just been to attract you to the roof to find that chest that was on the roof. Yeah, I think it was just to be like, you know, you light the fire, you see the smoke, now you come up here to investigate. And, oh look, there's a chest here. I think that's all that was. All right, in that case, then, let's go ahead and throw down a save and a GTFO, dude. Play a little bit of Pokemon TCG. Like I said, I haven't edited my deck or anything yet, so I'm probably going to get my ass kicked, to be honest with you. But that's fine. Just playing for fun anyways. We're going to go ahead and switch on over to the break screen while I shut down the PS2 and launch Pokemon TCG. But if you guys are ready, we'll go ahead and get started on that. Nate, I don't know if you're still around, but I know you were wanting to play too, so stay tuned, dude. Anyways, BRB, guys.